We thought of you with love today, but that is nothing new. We thought about you yesterday and days before that too. We think of you in silence. We often speak your name. Now all we have is memories and your picture in a frame. Your memory is our keepsake, with which we'll never part. God has you in his keeping. We have you in our hearts. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Paul Chidick, and it is my honour and privilege to be the celebrant for the funeral service today for Elsa Augusta Josephine Hardenberg. Born on the 28th of August 1938 in Makassar, Indonesia. And we're gathered here in this peaceful, beautiful chapel for all of us to pay our final tributes to and celebrate the life of Elsa, a much loved wife to John, mother of Johnny, Danny, and David, adored grandmother to six, great grandmother to three, and a cherished friend to many. We won't be concerned with time for the moment. We'll be leaving behind our other commitments and just concentrating on Elsa's farewell, concentrating on supporting her family and supporting each other. We each have the same purpose at a funeral, and that is to provide company and solace to each other, to assist each other to resolve our grief. We've had to deal with death and the pain of grief since time immemorial, and as human beings, we've developed rites to mark the passage of loved ones. From this relationship that we've enjoyed with Elsa to the next part of our relationship with her. And today we do this through this funeral service and these sacred traditions by which we farewell Elsa. The funeral service allows us to formally and publicly acknowledge our loss, give thanks for all the process of life that we enjoyed with Elsa, say our goodbyes, and then summer along, take up our own lives once more. Many people believe in a continuance of a life spirit beyond death, and I know that it would be impossible to believe that the memories that you have of Elsa would cease at the end of this service. The philosophy of the spirit continuing on is encapsulated in the explanation called togetherness. And I'd like to call Elsa's granddaughters, Stephanie and Jade, who are going to read that.
Thank you for joining us. Death is not the end of all. I have only slipped away into the next room. Whatever we were to each other, that we are still.
Call me by my old familiar name. Speak of me in the easy way which you always have.
Laugh as we always laughed at the little jokes that we enjoyed together. Play, smile, and think of me. Let my name be the household name that we always was.
Life means all that I ever meant. It is the same as it always was.
There is absolutely unbroken continuity.
Why should I be out of your mind just because I'm out of your sight? I'm waiting for you somewhere near, just around the corner.
One brief moment and all we will be as it was before, only better, infinitely better than forever together. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies. It was beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, it's at this point in the service, that we come to the soul of the funeral, and that is the eulogy and tributes. Without the eulogy, the funeral service is just so many words. The eulogy stimulates memories and feelings. The eulogy is Elsa's life history, her roots, her great successes. It's the story of her life. And I'd like to call upon Elsa's son, David, who's going to deliver that eulogy.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm David. I am the youngest son of John and Elsa, and I'd like to thank everyone for being here today. Mum would have absolutely loved you all be today, and she would have said, I like this. All right, some of you have travelled long distances from as far north Queensland and from as far as Holland. My brother Johnny, Rita, his wife, Stephanie, my niece. My mum was born in 1938 in Makassar, Hollandia. Makassar, Indonesia. Mum had three older siblings, Sonia, Franz, Dickie, and two younger siblings, Joop and Jimmy. My oma, who I never got to meet, passed away when my mum was quite young. And then my opa remarried and had four children, Winnie, Daisy, Heidi, and Shani. Mum and Dad met in Hollandia, New Guinea. Dad was only telling us the story the other day, how they met. It sounded very cheeky. He purposely rode his bike past her work so she would notice him. When Mum noticed him, he finally asked her out and he took her to the local lookout. Not long after that, they married. They had my brother, Johnny, and a few years later, my other brother, Danny, came along. Soon after World War II, Indonesia and New Guinea was a colony of the Netherlands. They had the opportunity to leave New Guinea and move to Holland and start a new life. Soon after, I came along. In 1973, Australia wanted immigrants to settle here, and Mum and Dad decided to go to Australia and start another new life. My mother Elsa was a warm, compassionate, and vibrant woman, always went out of her way to help others, no matter what. As a child, I always remember her caring for families in Indonesia and making sure they were fed all the way from Australia. She frequently sent them money to help. I also remember her sponsoring many children in third world countries, and she also regularly gifted to her church. She was a proud and dignified woman who had a passion for life. Mum had a wonderful sense of humour, which connected her to everyone she came into contact with. And it is a great testament to her nature that she formed so many long-lasting friendships over her 81 years. So many of you are here today. I've been getting messages from everywhere in the last couple of days, sending their condolence, but also telling me how Mum used to visit them and always help them out unconditionally. There are no words left unsaid. There are no feelings left unfelt. You knew you were loved by her because she showed it and forever told you that she loved you. I still see you and hear you every day. I can feel you here with us today. I will always talk to you. Growing up, you were an amazing mother. You always cared and always made sure everybody was okay. You were a loving and caring oma to your six grandchildren, Claudia, Stephanie, Jade, Kieran, Dallas, and Noah. I introduced Mum to Facebook, which she loved seeing all her friends and family and staying in touch. Rather than just pressing the like button on posts, she would often comment, I like this. It wasn't enough for her to just press the like button. I will miss her phone calls asking me to come over because something's not working on a computer. I will miss her filling my Facebook messages with love emojis. I will always remember you for the beautiful mum you were I admire your marriage to my beautiful dad. This is true love and unconditional love. Mum and dad were always, always together. They usually cook every meal together. And oh man, did they cook up a delicious feast, whether it was just for home or whether it was for parties, and all of you guys know that. They loved gardening together, they loved refurbishing old furniture together, and loved going to the casino together. But most of all, they loved each other so much. 12 months ago, Mum was rushed to hospital. She was admitted to the emergency department at Logan. The doctors were telling us to be prepared, as Mum might not make it through. That night, she pulled through. She wasn't ready to leave her husband, my dad. In the last 12 months, Mum made sure that Dad was going to be okay and he was cared for by her sons. Papa, we will always look after you. Okay? In the last few months, our dad cared for our mum nonstop. You displayed what true, true love is. I have so much respect for you. In her last week of life, she gathered us around her bed in hospital and she said to us, "Thank you for giving me a beautiful life." She also gave some advice, which was, always be yourself and don't let anybody influence you and tell you what to do. Do what you want to do. These are words that will always be cherished and close to my heart forever. One thing I know Mum would want is for all of us here to be happy and all to love one another. I love you, Mum. You will always be with us. Johnny and Rita's daughter, Claudia, unfortunately, she lives in Holland and can't be here with us. So Claudia, her husband, Sander, and their two beautiful children, Odin and Miles, live in Holland and could not be here today. They have sent their love by a video message.
Zo ben ik heel vaak wakker geworden, maar het was maar in mijn droom. De telefoon gaat, maar dit was geen nare droom. Je weet dat de telefoon ooit zou rinkelen om een niet leuk bericht te krijgen. Zaterdagochtend, 7 september. Oma is overleden. Tranen vloeien over mijn wangen. Ik voel me leeg. Gelukkig het verdriet met papa, mama, Stephanie en mijn gezinnetje kunnen delen. Gedachten en mooie herinneringen dwalen door mijn hoofd. Australië is ver, heel ver. Gelukkig heb ik mooie herinneringen met u kunnen maken. Samen koken, kletsen over het leven. Ook samen naar de Hunger Jacks. Met kerst samen naar muziek luisteren. Maar één ding is me echt heel erg bijgebleven. In 2004 keken we samen naar Australian Idol. En allebei waren we fan van Casey Donovan. Haar finale liedje, Listen With Your Heart. Daar hadden we allebei kippenvel van. En nu luister ik naar dit liedje en denk ik aan u. Lieve oma, ik zal u missen en altijd van u houden. En als ik een witte vlinder zie vliegen, zal ik u in mijn gedachten voorbij zien gaan. Heel veel dikke knuffels van ons allemaal. Een handkussen.
John Willis would like to come forward and pay his tribute to Elsa.
Hello, my name is John Willis. I'm one of Dave's best mates. So is my wife over there. Dave introduced us and got us together a long time ago. Dave has a lot of friends, and I'm honoured that he has asked me to say something about his beautiful mum. I first met Dave about 40 years ago, the spring of 1980, we met at the athletics carnival of Kingston High. We were competing in the high jump finals. Interestingly, his cousin Sylvester, Dave and myself were in the finals. Dave intrigued me. I'd never seen anybody do the high jump Western roll style. That's when you dive head over the high jump first. Bit dangerous, but it looks really cool. Cousin Sylvester did the more standard scissors and I did the frisbee flop. I did beat them, but only just. Dave was more the hurdler, and thank goodness he didn't dive head first over the hurdles. No one could beat Dave in the hurdles, and he was a beautiful hurdler. He made it all the way to the state championships. He was an all-round sportsman, and it was at that moment we became friends, and we were literally peas in a pod, inseparable mates throughout high school, and this is where I got to meet Dave's family. Beautiful Hardenbergs. When Dave asked me to say something today, I asked him, "What do you want me to say, Dave?" He said, "Brother, just speak from the heart." This is my heart talking now. I'll do my best. But my heart, brother, my heart is breaking for you. It's really hard to say goodbye to a mama. She was a beautiful person. We respectfully called her Mrs. Hardenberg. You say to speak from the heart. Well, Mrs. Hardenberg was all heart. She did everything with her heart and for her family. Your heart is most on display when you meet somebody new. And that somebody new was me 40 years ago when Dave introduced me to his mum and dad. It went a little bit like this. "Davey, who is your friend?" "This is John. He's from Papua New Guinea. Davey, tell him to come eat." My goodness, Mrs. Hardenberg food was the best ever creation from the heart. "Dave, what are those little chippy things that your mum makes? Can I have some more? What's that beef woolly stuff? I just love it. I can't get enough of it." I never saw Mrs. Hardenberg angry. She also always had a beautiful smile on her face. She offered me food and those beautiful cups of coffee with Coffee Mate, which I still have Coffee Mate today. We had a lot of conversations and got to spend a lot of time with Mrs. Hardenberg when my sister and her husband moved in next door to the Hardenbergs. Thank you, Mrs. Hardenberg, for creating three beautiful sons. And one of those sons, your youngest, is one of my best mates. Somebody a lot wiser than me once said, "You don't have to set the rules if you lead by example." And Mrs. Hardenberg led by example. I'll always remember Dave and I celebrating our 17th birthday at our house in Woodridge. We had a double party. It's about this time, 40 years ago. Oh no, a little bit more. Not 40, but you know what I mean. Mum and Dad and Mr. and Mrs. Hardenberg were sitting on the veranda with big smiles on their faces, watching us crazy guys have one of the biggest parties ever in Logan. A lot of those friends are here with us today. The Hardenbergs made friends wherever they went. We had a lot of international friends, and they do this because they are beautiful people. You only attract friends through your heart, and that is exemplified through Mrs. Hardenberg. Mrs. Hardenberg's heart was always on display and always available to anybody. She was just an amazing woman. We're gonna miss you, and it was an absolute pleasure to know you. Thank you.
Thank you, John, for that wonderful tribute. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that you each have your own personal memories of Elsa, So let's just reflect for a moment on what Elsa meant to each of us. We'll just sit quietly and we'll watch this DVD photo montage celebrating Elsa's life.
Only you can make all this world seem right. Only you can make the darkness bright. Only
As we accept life, so must we also accept death. For life and death are inseparable and part of the same process, and because of this, death will come to each of us just as it has come to Elsa. But the thing to always remember is that you each shared a unique relationship with Elsa, and that relationship will always be unique and always continue, though now just in a different form. I know that we never really lose the people we love, even in death, because they continue to participate in every act, thought, and decision that we make. Their love leaves an indelible imprint on our memories, and we find comfort from knowing that having shared their love, it has enriched our lives. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the most difficult part of the service, and that is the committal, where we say our final farewell to Elsa. And I would respectfully request that we all stand for the committal, if that's comfortable for you to do so. Today, we say goodbye to Elsa. Her life cycle is complete. Left behind are memories of Elsa to give comfort to all those who remember her. Elsa Augusta Josephine Hardenberg, your life we honour, your departure we accept, and your memory we cherish. In grief at your death, but in gratitude for your life and for the privilege of sharing it with you, we commit your body to be cremated. We are grateful for Elsa's life that has been lived well and for all that her life has meant to us. We now leave our friend Elsa in peace. With respect, we bid her farewell. Let us leave her in quietness of spirit and live with care and affection for each other. The 23rd Psalm of David has comforted many generations of grieving families. It describes the Lord as a shepherd, gently guiding his flock through peaceful pastures towards a life of comfort and love. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures, he leads me beside still waters, he restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all of the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And ladies and gentlemen, I ask that you join with me as I recite the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated, ladies and gentlemen. I would sincerely like to thank Elsa's family for allowing me to carry out proceedings as celebrant for her service today. And on behalf of myself and Leah from Michael Hutchinson Funerals, we offer our sincere condolences to you all. And the family's also asked me to convey to each of you that your expressions of sympathy and love, your compassion and your support by being here today is very much appreciated. Thank you. And the families also ask that you join them for refreshments after the service at the River Glen Haven Retirement Village at 74 Butel Street at Waterford West, and there share your memories of Elsa. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our service for today. And in a moment, we'll be playing one final song. And I ask that during that song, you just reflect on your memories of Elsa. The funeral director, Leah, will come forward at the appropriate time, and then we'll call for the pallbearers. Thank you.
Now I'm not trying to teach you how to live, but I've got something I guess you all ought to know. Now listen, try a little love is what Mama used to say. Son, try a little love and pains will go. Well, I want you to sing together with me.